morning to the student. I'm YG Sonje, assistant teacher in Nemina Jain High School, Chandler. Welcome all of you in standard 5th. Today we are going to learn subject mathematics, unit fractions and subunit equivalent fractions. Before to know equivalent fractions, we must know the fractions. I revived the fractions. Here, look at this picture. In this picture, it is a one complete bhakri, which is denoted by this sign or number 1. This number is a complete number. Now, I divide this bhakri into two people, into two equal parts. Each will get half part of this bhakri. This half part is shown by the lines or color lines. Okay? And this half part is shown in digit. Here, 1 out of 2. This digit or number called as fraction. In this fraction, the 1 in the middle line, above that line, number 1 is called as a numerator. While below the middle line, a number is called as denominator. Okay, and this number is called as fraction, means half is equal to 1 upon 2. It is read as 1 upon 2. Okay, this is the fraction. Now, to know the equivalent fraction, I explain it with the help of another example. Look at picture. This is a 1 bhakri and I make 4 equal parts of that bhakri. Out of that 4 parts, I take 2 parts and which is shown as it is, means 2 upon 4. It is read as 2 upon 4. And here 2 is the numerator and 4 is the denominator. Okay, and read as 2 upon 4, means this 2 upon 4 part is similar to the half part. Here this half is shown as 2 upon 4. Okay, third example. Here I take a watermelon and cut it into the 6 equal parts and divided into 2 chunks. Okay, how many parts? 6 parts divided into 2 group or 2 chunks. Each one will get 3 parts. Look here, 1 2 3, 1 2 3, each one will get 3 parts from the 6 part, which is shown as 3 upon 6. Actually, I will get, or each student will get half part. This is also half part of the watermelon. Okay? Means here, the half part is shown by the digit or fraction 1 upon 2, okay, 2 upon 4, and third one, 3 upon 6. All these fractions have a equal value. So I can write it as 1, therefore 1 upon 2 is equal to 2 upon 4 is equal to 3 upon 6. Okay. Here we can say that these fractions have an equal value, so these are called as equivalent fractions. Okay, so we can define the fractions which have the fractions of an equal value are called equivalent fractions. Fractions have an equal value. Called as equivalent fraction. Look at this circle. This circle is divided into three equal parts. 1, 2, 3. Out of these three parts, two parts are colored. This can be shown with the fraction 2 upon 3. 2 is the numerator, 3 is the denominator. This circle again divided into 6 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Out of these 6 parts, I colored 4 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 parts as a color part. Okay. These four parts are equal to these two colored parts. Means this portion is similar to this portion. This portion is 2 upon 3 and this one is 4 upon 6 are equal. So we can write in this way, 2 upon 3 is equal to 4 upon 6 because both fractions have a same value. That's why these are called as equivalent fraction. Now, how we can obtain the equivalent fraction? Let us see. Now, here I draw a rectangle and I divided it into 5 equal parts. Out of these 5 parts, 2 parts are colored, which can be shown with the fraction 2 upon 5. Okay, now I draw 2 cross lines to this figure and I will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. 15 equal parts of the figure. Out of these 15 parts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 parts are colored. So we can write with fraction 6 upon 15 are the colored part. Okay, but these 6 parts are equal to the these 2 parts, means this portion is similar to this portion, this portion is similar to this portion. That's why this fraction is similar to this fraction. So we can write 2 upon 5 is equal to 6 upon 15. These two fractions have a equal value. So they are equivalent fractions. Okay. Now let us see the relation between two equivalent fractions. Here 6 is the numerator of one fraction and 2 is the other. 6 is 3 times of 2, while denominator 15 is the denominator of one fraction and 5 is the other fraction. 15 is 3 times of 5. It means what? The numerator of one fraction
is as many times of the other fraction and denominator of one fraction is as many times of the other fraction. This is the relation between two equivalent fraction. In these three examples, the numerator and denominator of one fraction is as many times numerator and denominator of other fraction. Look at this example. We can say that when numerator and denominator of a fraction are multiplied, by the same non-zero number, we get a fraction that is to the given fraction. Here means the numerator and denominator of fractions are multiplied by the same non-zero number. Means here 2 upon 5 is the fraction. We multiplied by the same number to the numerator and denominator. Here we multiply to the numerator by 3 and denominator by 3. 2 into 3 means 6 and 5 into 3 means 15. Here 2 upon 5 is similar or equivalent fraction to the 6 upon 15. In this way, this multiplicand must be non-zero number, we can say. Now we can get equivalent fraction by dividing the similar non-zero number to the numerator and denominator also. For example, here 6 upon 15 is the fraction and we divide this fraction to the numerator and denominator by the same number, that is a 3. We will get 6 divided by 3 and 15 divided by 3, we will get 2 upon 5, which is similar to 6 upon 15. In this way, we can obtain the equivalent fraction by multiplying or dividing the similar number to the numerator and denominator. If the numerator and denominator have common divisor, then the fraction we get on dividing them by that divisor is equivalent to the given fraction. We clear this rule by solving some example. Here 6 upon 12 is the fraction. We divide this fraction by same divisor to the numerator and denominator. The divisor is 2. So look at here, 6 divided by 2 to the denominator, 12 divided by 2. Here 2 is the same divisor to the numerator and denominator. We will get 3 upon 6. We will get 3 upon 6. This is the equivalent fraction to the 6 upon 12. Again, we divide this 6 upon 12 by same divisor 3. 6 upon 6 divided by 3 upon 12 divided by 3. We will get 2 upon 4. Okay. Now, here again we divide this 6 upon 12 by same divisor 6. 6 upon 12 is equal to 6 divided by 6 to the denominator, 12 divided by 6. We will get 6 ones are 6, 6 twos are 12, 1 upon 2. All these 3 means 3 upon 6, 2 upon 4, 1 upon 2 are equivalent fraction to the 6 upon 12. Okay, we can write similarly, 6 upon 12 is equal to 3 upon 6 equal to 2 upon 4 and 1 upon 2. Here we verify this rule by these 3 examples. Now you solve the problem set 17 on your home.